Hey guys, how's it going? Chez back again. Welcome to the second episode of the Twitch stream series. I'm in the process of going live right now, but if you're watching this over on YouTube, then skip forward a few minutes because I'll spend the opening 3-4 minutes or so just setting up the stream and welcoming people in, and then I'll try and tie in when I load up the game in the background with where the stream actually begins proper. So first things first though, thank you for the incredible support on the first stream that went up the other day. We had almost 1,000 likes and almost 20,000 views as I record this, or stream this second episode. So thank you very much for all the support on the first. If you want to see these streams live and not have to wait for them to go up on YouTube, then there is a link in the description down below to my Twitch channel where you can follow over there. I do go live every single evening at 8:45 p.m. So if you want to come over and watch me live, then that's the place to do it. But I'm going to switch off from the YouTube intro and switch to the Twitch intro and start saying hello to people in my chat. So if you're watching on YouTube, skip forward a few minutes and then you'll see in the background where we'll actually bring the game up and actually get cracking. But for now, hello guys, welcome to the stream. How's it going? I'm just going to try and get Nightbot in. Nightbot is having some issues though. I think the website is actually down right now. I'm just actually going to quickly check their Twitter to see if they're down, if they've tweeted about it. They haven't tweeted for 6 days. Well, that bodes well, doesn't it? I click join chat for Nightbot and nothing happens. And the site wouldn't load for me a moment ago, so. Hey guys, how's it going? Can you see me? Because I can't see me on my stream in front of me. Oh, no, it is finally loading. It took forever to load. But now it's loaded. Okay, that's good. We are live. Hi! Do it for the beard. Subscribe for 6 months in a row. Thank you very much for subscribing, Jack. I appreciate that, my man. And for the no identity purchase earlier on today as well. Thank you very much for your support. I appreciate that. I was about to say, if you can't see me, refresh. But if you can't see me, you won't be able to hear me say refresh. If I'm not live on your screen, hit refresh. Smiley face. Tottenham Tom just subscribed. Thank you very much, Tom. I appreciate that, my man. We'll give you the cheeky sub hype in the chat as well. A subscription to my Twitch channel to celebrate Tottenham going 2-0 up for you just before half-time as well. Thank you very much, Tom. You have been subscribed previously, haven't you? So that's technically a resub, but in the grand scheme of things, you are sub number 72. Thank you very much. I will update my overlay quickly in the background. We will be doing the subscriber giveaway tomorrow. So if you are subscribed to the Twitch channel, and, well, you don't have to be in the stream to win the giveaway, but, you know, it would be nice if you were here to receive or to hear live that you are involved or winning the giveaway. Then that will be tomorrow night on the 3rd. So feel free to come back tomorrow as well. Let me just quickly update the overlay. So it says 72 subscribers. There we go. How's it going there, guys? Are you all right? That was my chair, not me, by the way. Just point that out. I have a really squeaky chair right now. I'm trying to get hold of a new one. Is Spencer still streaming? He's not. Spencer was streaming Football Manager 2016 earlier on today. And he had just over 2,000 viewers. So I wasn't sure how popular this stream might be. But he's gone offline. So maybe that'll mean we'll get more numbers. Who knows? Who knows? What is it? 10 to 9. Has it tweeted out for me? It should have done. If it has, it has. Good. Right, let me upload the little notification video to let people know that we're live. I meant to do that a moment ago, but I forgot, Ed. Copy. Just put this live, and then we will get cracking. Uploaded that one. Oh. Your changes are being saved. Please save. Is Nightbot in the chat? It's not. No, Nightbot appears to be dead today for some reason. Don't know why. Hopefully it will be back tomorrow. Pardon me. Right. Have those changes saved? They have. That's going live. Good. I will tweet out as well. Football Manager 2016 stream, and we're in the transfer window. Come join in the chat. There we go. There we go. Right. Load last game. Let's get cracking. I have transferred across my face pack files from FM15 into FM16. So we do now have badges for Barclays Premier League sides, and we do now have faces for Barclays Premier League sides and a few other of the big sides. I didn't want to actually do that. What I wanted to do was this. So we do now have badges for BPL sides, which is fantastic. We do have kits for BPL sides other than the newly promoted sides. So Norwich don't have kits, unfortunately. And Bournemouth don't have kits either. Because I'm using my 2015 file, and obviously they weren't involved in the Barclays Premier League last year. Watford are actually licensed this year properly. So that's why they have their kits on there being a promoted side. But everybody else, I mean, I think they're last year's kits. I don't think they're this year's kits. I think they're last year's kits. But still, it's better than it being default, isn't it? And then as soon as there is an FM16 one available, as soon as there's a 16 one available, I will obviously update it. Obviously update it. But we are 4 days away from the first game in League 2 right now. 4 days away. How much does the shirts cost in euros? I can check for you, bro. It's £12. So I believe, if I check that, if I just go currency converter, I think it should be, it's been about €15, I think. What's 12? 16 euros 79 cent. That's what the no ID shirts are. That's what the no ID shirts are. Although I can't unfortunately put the commands in because Nightbot is broken, unfortunately. I can, if you do want links put in the chat, then I will have to manually link them. So just give me time. With that regard, if you want stuff linked in the chat, I can link you stuff, but obviously it will take me a while. But that is the no identity site there. But yes, we have made one signing so far this season. Obviously, we made that in the first episode. We signed John Akinde from Barnet for £195,000. And he's come in. He should be, hopefully, pretty damned good for us this year. He's probably going to be one of my starting strikers. Probably put him alongside Barry Corr, to be completely honest, although Barry's not exactly anywhere near remote fitness now. We have obviously brought in Peter Brzovan as well on a free, I think we got him for, didn't we? Yes. He was at Tranmere last season. We've picked him up on a free. And stat-wise, he's better than any of the other goalkeepers we've got at the club. So, seemed like a good idea to me. I just got a donation as well. Let me check that. It's £1 from Tottenham Tom. Says, been busy lately, so haven't been around. Won't be here Thursday going to watch Spurs. Oh, you're going to the Europa League game, are you? Dele Alli scored a good goal, though, to finish off. Oh, I didn't realise. I've had the football on, but not been paying attention to it. I didn't realise Frank Lampard was in the studio with the boys tonight. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Frank's back. Anyway, we've got a couple of players out injured at present. Hopefully that's not going to cause us too many problems for the first game of the season, but time will tell. We have been offering new contracts around as well, and we want to scout the Cup at One Cup. Fair enough, I'll scout the Cup at One Cup if you would like me to. We have been putting in loan requests. We set up in the first episode, if you missed the first stream, we set up a parent affiliate club link with Chelsea, and we are getting João Rodriguez on loan. So he may actually be the partner for John Akinde, to be completely honest. And Barry Corr might have a bit of a different spot. Although, to be fair, there's plenty of games to be played, so everybody will get first-team football at some point. Rodriguez has been labelled the next Falcao. It's quite high praise, to be completely honest. Really? I've never even bothered looking at this guy. Lorenzo Tempesti. To be fair, we've got enough strikers right now. I don't need another one. I don't need another one. We were looking for a wide midfielder. There we go. Was set to make managerial debut. I should probably update my face, shouldn't I? Probably get a selfie in there or something. Can I, if I go home in my profile, can I update my profile and put a picture in there? I don't know how to do that, to be honest. You guys probably know how to do that better than me. I may have to do it from the actual settings itself. Currently, we don't have any reputation whatsoever, but that's fair enough. Because we haven't managed at all, ever. Brackley affiliate scout report. Yeah, that was legitness. It's a Football Manager advert on TV right now, I think. Nasser Chadli and Spencer FC in it, which is mental. We did just get a donation. It's £1 from Omul0920. Says, hi, Tez, what processor do you need for Football Manager? Not sure if my Intel Core i3 would work. Can you tell me? If you go onto Steam, bro, let me load up Steam on the screen in front of you. If I go to games, and then it actually might be easier to search for it on the store so that you can then, take me to the store. Football Manager 2016, and then if you go onto the Steam page for FM 2016 and scroll down, you'll see system requirements down here. These are the minimum system requirements to be able to run FM properly. You could probably run it on a worse machine, but you'd have to say that these are probably the best, or the minimum really, to be able to run it properly. But an Intel Pentium 4 is, you know, you'd quite easily be able to run it on your i3. You'd definitely be able to run it on your i3. You only need 2 GB of RAM to run it as well. So your i3 should be fine for FM, I would have thought. Right, our competition expectations review. They want us to finish in the top half of League 2. They want us to get to the second round of the FA Cup, which obviously the first round of which hasn't been drawn yet, so we don't know how good our chances are of making it through to the second round. They just don't want us to get outclassed in the Capital One Cup. We have got Championship side Brentford as our opponent, so there is a risk of being outclassed there, but hopefully we won't be. And then the minimum expectation for the Johnson's Paint Trophy is to reach the second round of that cup competition as well. But obviously, again, the draw hasn't been made there. Oh, it's about to be made. There you go. Now we're going to know. Now, I haven't decided what the prize is for the giveaway yet, Luke. Probably going to be a console code or two. And then next month, I'll add in no identity t-shirts, etc. But I haven't set my first order yet, so I don't have any stock as of present because we're only in a pre-order stage. But Johnson's Paint Trophy, right, who do you think we're going to get? Suggestions in the chat. You can see the teams at the bottom of the screen. Got Wimbledon, Barnet, Bristol Rovers, Colchester, Exeter, Gillingham, Leighton Orient, Luton, Newport, now Northampton, Peterborough, Portsmouth, Southend, Wickham and Yeovil. Probably can't see all of them because I think the overlay actually covers some of them at the bottom. But I'm trying to scroll up so you can see them. Can you see that? Let me, if I do that. Portsmouth, yeah. There's Wickham and Yeovil on the bottom as well as Southend and Portsmouth there. But who do you think we're going to get? Always like to do this when we have a cup draw. We always see who guesses what, and then we'll see what we get. That was legitness. Just got another donation. I will check that in a second. A lot of shouts for Newport. A lot of shouts for Newport. We'll go to automatic draw, so it does it as it would do in a real life draw. We just got another donation of almost 920. It says, thanks, Chase, but what do you think of Money getting the sack? I think it was the right time for Money to go, personally. If you're not sure what he means by Money getting the sack, Cambridge United sacked their manager in real life today after 3 years at the club. And personally, I believe it was the right time. We've been drawn against Wimbledon, fellow League Two side Wimbledon, away from home. I would have preferred a home draw, to be honest. But never mind. At least it's not far. Wimbledon is just down the road in... Well, I know, to be fair, it's South London, isn't it, Wimbledon? Cambridge is about 45 minutes north of London, but... Now everybody in the chat, now that it's come up, are going, oh, I think you'll get Wimbledon away, Trez. GG, boys. Selection criteria. Minimum of at least 6 players that were used in the previous official first team. Oh, okay. I wasn't aware that there were rules like that in the Johnson's Paint Trophy, but we are about to play our first ever game. Our first ever game. We're going to play the 4-4-2. And we'll start with Brazovan in goal. At right back, I said I wanted to play Elliot Omazuzi. Everybody's conditioning is pretty terrible right now. Everybody's pretty tired for some reason. Doesn't fill me with overly large amounts of confidence. I put Leon Legg and Josh Coulson as my centre-backs. Go away, please. And then left back, we'll go with... I was going to go with George Taft, I think, rather than Mickey. Although I could go with Mickey Demetriou, I suppose. He's not very quick, though. That's the only thing. But he is good in the tackle, and he does work hard. So, all right, we'll go with Mikey Demetriou. On the right-hand side of midfield, we're going to put Colin Newton out there, because he has decent crossing and is quite quick. In the centre of midfield... We are going to go with Luke Berry in the support position, or the automatic position. And then my ball-winning midfielder is going to be... Well, see, I would play Keith Keane, but his Keith Keane's fitness is quite low. Did I just see in the chat someone subscribing for such and such month in a row? I did. Premier Luke Powers subscribed for 4 months in a row. Thank you very much, Luke. I appreciate that, my man. If you could stop... spam in the chat, that would be very much appreciated. Thank God. Right, I was going to go with Keith Keane, but he's pretty... Oh no, condition is 97. It's just match sharpness that's quite low. Okay. We'll go with Keith Keane then. Oh, because I was just looking at these on the right-hand side, but that's sharpness. On the left-hand side, you can see its conditioning is fine. So clearly I was just being a derp. Or you with being a derp. Anyway, on the left-hand side, we're definitely going with Jeff Hughes. But as you can see, this is kind of why I'd like an extra wide player, because we don't have that many, you know, great options in wide positions. Then up top, we are going to go with John Akinde. And do we go with Zé Rodríguez? Or do we give him time to settle in first? We'll give him time to... but Barry Cole's match sharpness is 55%. He's going to need first team football, though, to be fair, if he's going to get fit. So we might as well give it to him. We'll put Sam Besant on the bench. We've just got a new subscriber, CCFC2001, just subscribed. Thank you very much, my man. I appreciate that very much indeed. Everybody's spamming the sub hype and the thumbs up in the chat. Cheers, bro. I appreciate that. I will adjust my overlay accordingly, because we're now up to 73 subscribers. That's fantastic. Thank you very much for that. Let's do... I want to sort by position. There we go, that's better. I'm just getting the order of my players on my list mixed up at the minute, but obviously with it being a new game, it hasn't remembered my preferences from FM15. So I'm just going to have to fiddle with those slightly, but that'll be fine. So we've got Sam Besant on the bench. Let's put... Well, Greg Taylor's currently injured, so we'll put George Taft on the bench. We'll also put Harrison Dunk on the bench. Could do with another centre-back, maybe, couldn't we, really? Although, I guess when Keith Keane gets back from injury, and Greg Taylor will be all right. And Mark Roberts, for that matter. Oh no, Keith Keane's already in the lineup, isn't he? Did I put Keith Keane in? I think I did, didn't I, at CDM? So what position? There we go, Chess. Yeah, I did. There he is. It's starting. Let's put Liam Hughes on the bench. Let's put Ryan Donaldson on the bench, definitely. Rory Gaffney. And who else should we put on the bench? I mean, Robbie Simpson can play midfield and up top. Go on then, we'll put Robbie Simpson on. We'll put Robbie Simpson on the bench. Lacking in match sharpness and may struggle. But they're not going to get shut up if they don't play. That's the only thing. All right. Well, we'll start Rory Gaffney then. But we'll bring Barry Corr off the bench to see if we can actually get him. Actually, what is Ryan Donaldson has 8 tackling. What is Barry's tackling? 11. You know what? Let's put Barry in that role, and we'll put Keith Keane on the bench, and we'll start Ryan Donaldson at centre mid. I could play Connor Newton at centre mid. What's Donaldson's crossing, etc.? Crossing of 11. See, they're both really good. So I'll play Donaldson. Pardon me. I'll play Donaldson. I'll play Donaldson centrally. There we go. Although, go on then. We'll put Donaldson wide right. Although, do they? Yeah, they're better that way around. Right. I think we're set then. You can go away. I don't need you. Yeah. Let's go ask squad numbers. You can have 12. Right, you'll have to let me know what the in-game audio levels are like. If I need to turn them up or turn them down, I will judge by what your reflections and responses in the chat. But we are favourites for this one. We are evens, and Newport are 11-5. But it's not going to be easy. They are a decent side, Newport. Playing a 5-3-2 or a 3-5-2. It's probably a 5-3-2, isn't it, that one? We're playing, obviously, the straight 4-4-2. Don't feel confident in my ability enough to give any tactical advice at this time. All right. Okay. Nobody feels confident enough to be able to give me... Okay. That's different. Something to just a random FYI... Not FYI, but random... Random fact, Matt Walker, the fitness coach here, was my PE teacher at sixth form. I can't put music in the background of the Football Manager streams because they go up on YouTube, and if I put music in them, they will obviously get copyright struck, so I can't. I'm going to tell them to do it for the fans today. We'll see how we get on. Obviously, there's a new 3D engine, as there is every year. Hopefully we can have a decent first game of the season. That's a good cross. How is that for a goal on your debut after 1.5 minutes? John Akinde gets us off to a fantastic start. 1-0 Cambridge United, boys. How good's that? Immediately. You want me to turn it down? It's too loud. Okay, I'll turn it down. There we go. Consider it turned down. And there comes the goal spam as well. I forgot we'd added that. We'd added that emoticon in. Rory Gaffney's in behind. Oh, Rory Gaffney scored a screamer! Rory Gaffney! 2-0 after 7 minutes. Boys! We're flying. We're absolutely flying. We're absolutely flying. That's crazy. That's a madness. I have used non-copyright music previously, Julian, on YouTube, but further down the line, that previously non-copyright music, the artist got signed, and then I got copyright strikes on all of the old stuff that had his music in, so I just don't take the risk anymore. It's not worth it. But we couldn't have asked for a better start, really, could we? 70% possession, 2 chances on goal, and 2 shots. Well, two chances on goal, two shots and two goals. Make that three shots, three goals. What on earth is going on? 9 minutes in, we're 3-0 up. What is going on? I mean, I'll take it. 9 minutes in, we are 3-0 up. Jeff Hughes with two assists. John Akinde with a brace on his debut. This is mental! I'm going to tweet this out. This is crazy. Please don't spam the chat, Toby. I'd appreciate it if you didn't. Let me tweet this out. Make that 3-1. Make that 3-1. We were 3-0 up, as I tweeted out saying we're 3-0 up. And unfortunately, we've conceded. Oh well. Nana Tuamasi just scored with their only shot of the game, but we're on the attack again. Elliot Omazuzi into John Akinde. He's working his socks off right now for the team. Nice bit of footwork to get it to Connor Newton. Squares it in. Liam Hughes. Rory Gaffney! It's 4-1 after 39 minutes. I can't even. We are 4-1 up. 4-1 up. Rory Gaffney and John Akinde with a brace each. I'm pretty pleased we made the decision to put Barry Core on the bench and put Rory Gaffney in the starting lineup, aren't you? This is crazy.
Bruh.
This is nuts. I'm going to assertively say I'm very pleased with your performance. Keep it up. What else could I say? That's mental. Come on, the boys. Barry Corey is one of the best strikers at League 2 level, Kevin. He scored goals season in, season out for Southend in League 2. And Cambridge signed him in real life. At the beginning of this season. Please don't score again. Thank you. I've got substitution. I might think about making some subs in a minute just to freshen things up. Make sure that people don't get tired. Luke Berry's starting to get a little bit tired, so we'll put Keith Keane on in that ball-winning midfielder role. And Josh Coulson is taking a knock, but we don't... I could really do with another centre-back, couldn't I, really? I think that's the one place we need to look to improve. Centre-back and wide midfielder, to be honest. And do we put George Taft on for now? We'll leave it as things are for now. I'm just going to calmly say, pressure's off. No pressure. Unless, of course, they score a second here, in which case... No, they're not going to score a second here, so it's fine. 4-1. This is mad. I should put myself up for the managerial role in real life. Somehow I don't quite think I'd be good enough. Oh, that's a finish. 4-2. How's this for an entertaining game? Your first in management. Slightly annoyed that we've conceded two goals. But it's a good finish from John Lewis. Good cross. Don't lose it there, Elliot. Thank you. Calling a 5-4 loss. I hope not. Tom Elliott left. Real Chef Wednesday fan. We sold him. Or he just left. What? They've got a penalty. I think they're going to make it 4-3 with a few minutes to go. Please miss. He hasn't. Shit the bed. This is getting serious now, boys. It's getting serious now. I want to put Liam Hughes on. as well in midfield. It's 4-3. It's 4-3. This is just the way I prefer to have the layout, Beardy, so I'm going to leave it as this, sorry. I've always liked to have the match stats and the pitch side by side like this. We're almost at the very end of the game now. Oh. Oh. 3-0 up after 9 minutes. Can't say as I'm too impressed with our defending, but I will assertively congratulate the side. Good win, boys. Well done. We're second in the league after one game, although conceding three when they have 34% possession and only 4 shots on target, that is. Not necessarily the best. But never mind. Really pleased with our attacking performance. Really pleased with our attacking performances. Rory Gaffney scored 2 in his debut, as did John Akinde. Rory Gaffney. Jeff Hughes gets 3 assists as well. Said that he was going to be incredible on that left-hand side, and he proved to be. And Greg Taylor's back from injury as well. That's good. Right. How long are you out for, Mark Roberts? Another 6 days, 2 weeks. Do 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 do. I could play Keith Keane. No. Just trying to think. We have. How much money have we got left? We've got about a million left. I would like a centre back and a wide midfielder. There should be a follow. There is a follow button. The bash. If you're on PC, if you look underneath the stream, there's a little follow button. And if you're on the app, there will be a little love heart on the screen. If you tap the screen, like where the video is, it will pop up with a little love heart in the top right-hand corner. If you hit that, that's the way to follow the stream. So if you guys know of any centre-backs or... Let's have a look at the transfer list, shall we? Transfer status listed. And then we will filter realistic transfers. We are looking for position... Can play centre back. Zubar. Stefan Zubar is available. Really? He's on £10,000 a week, though. That could be an issue, but I will get a scout report on him nonetheless. Steve McNulty. Lol. Right, there's nobody really on the transfer list that. Well. We undo realistic transfers. Richard Wood at Rotherham. That would be a good signing. I'd be keen on bringing in Richard Wood. What do you guys think of Richard Wood? I'll get a scout report. His stats look really good. And he's 6'3". He's only on £4,000 a week. I will have a look for some of the names that you're putting in the chat, though. Gavin Gunning, that's a name that I definitely recognise. He used to play in Scotland, didn't he? He's at Sheffield United. Have they just signed him? They have just signed him this year, and he's played in the first game of the season, so we won't be able to get Gavin Gunning. It was Dundee he was at in Scotland. I thought it was. I thought it was. Gareth McCauley at West Brom. Won't be able to afford his wages, unfortunately. We'll have a look at some of your suggestions in the chat. Sergio Ramos, yeah, cheers, sir. Thanks for that. Scott Tancock, let's have a look at you. Who are you? Okay. Hello, FM. What are you doing? Scott Tancock. Merthyr Tydfil. I'll scout him. There's no harm in scouting him. There's no harm in scouting him. What else have we got in the chat? People like Paddy McNair, I would never be able to get. They would never come down as low as League 2. Connor Dyson, a wide player from Everton. Have a look. We'll have a look. We are looking potentially for a wide midfielder. So, no results found for Connor Dyson. Is it 1N? No. Well, we'll look for just Dyson. This Callum Dyson, not Connor Dyson. Was that the guy you were thinking of? But he's a striker. Stefan O'Connor from Arsenal. I have a funny feeling, though, a lot of the BPL players just won't be willing to drop to our level. You have to bear in mind, we're in League 2. I'll scout him. But you have to, like I say, you have to bear in mind that we're in League 2, so we're not the most appealing of transfer destinations. Axel Twanzebe? Is that what it was? Twanzebe. Axel Twanzebe. Who dat? Centre back from Man United's under 21s. He's quick. He's got stamina of 1 to 9, which immediately puts me off. A work rate of 3 to 11. Nope. Not keen on his stats, TBH. You know who I am going to look at? And those of you that watched the career mode Road to Glory last year on FIFA will recognise this name. Paul Downing. He's valued at 400 grand, which is a shame, because that's a lot of money. I don't know whether he'd drop down as far as, you know, whether he'd drop down a division to come play for us, but he would be incredible. Look, I will prove to you that people like, you keep putting Paddy McNair in the chat. He's too good for League 2. He's too good. He will not come to a League 2 side. He's too good. He won't come. I need players that aren't that good. Jordan Pataka. That name rings a bell, but I don't know why. Why does that name ring a bell? Jordan Pataka, where was it? There we go. Chat's moving. I may have to put slow mode on in a moment because I'm struggling to keep up with the chat. Jordan Pataka. Why would he ever come to me? Look at those stats. He's on 2.5 grand a week. They've just signed him for 1.1 million. He would never in a bajillion years come out on loan to me. Plus he's injured. With a dislocated jaw. Yeah, let me put slow mode on. Obviously, if you're a subscriber, you won't be affected by slow mode. Well, not slow mode doesn't appear to have made much of a difference, to be completely honest. The chat is still going mental. Free agent. I could have a look at free agents. Josh Meekings, who's that? I'm just taking names at random from the chat right now to just have a look at them. Centre back from Inverness. He looks rock solid, but again, it's the question of would he drop down to League 2 level? Oliver Burke. That name was brought up a couple of times last stream, and I don't think I actually looked for it. Oliver Burke of Falkirk. We'll scout him. He always popped up on the career mode Road to Glory last year in the early episodes and I never actually followed him up. Ryan Innes, that's a name that rings a bell as well. Although, is it? I think I'm thinking of a different Innes. Pretty sure I am thinking of a different Innes. Stamina of 5 to 10, again, just doesn't appeal. I'll get a scout report, but physically looks pretty weak. Overall, obviously he had strength of like 12 to 18, but you know what I mean. Regan Poole. Who's Regan Poole? I'll scout him. I'd prefer to buy someone, though. I'd prefer to buy someone than loan a youngster from the Premier League. I'd rather buy someone with experience. It's all piss. Natural fitness, 3 to 7. Meh. Meh. How about no? I've got a funny feeling, Beardy, that you're not on the game. Curtis Good. Why does that name ring a bell? Centre back at Oldham, 22 years. I tell you what, he looks quality. He's very expensive. He's earning £0 a week. That's because he's on loan, that's why. He's already on loan at Oldham. From Newcastle. John Taylor, he's the rapid guy from Shrewsbury, isn't he? Alright, he's at Peterborough now, apparently. He was at Shrewsbury. He's first team at Peterborough, and he's also very expensive. Not a chance. Not a chance, I'm afraid. Let's have a look. Here, can play all midfielders. Nuri Sahin, how about now? We'll just quickly use the realistic transfers option. Miles Weston, he's rapid, but can't cross the ball for shit. So we won't get him. Will Atkinson. Why does that name ring? Was he at Rochdale? He was at Rochdale. Only on loan, though. That's weird. I think I'm thinking of someone else. Another Will that was at Rochdale. Lewis Dodds. Dodds could be decent. I'll get a scout report on Lewis Dodds. Chris Weltdale. Again, good experience. Fantastic tackling. I will get a scout report on Chris Weltdale. Actually could be quite a good signing, Weltdale. Alex Lawless is a solid player, but he's 30 years old now. Jake Howells is another guy at Luton that is on the transfer list. But he's a left mid. I don't need a left mid. Clearly Jeff Hughes is good enough on the left-hand side. If we do buy someone that can play on the left, I'd rather buy someone that can play on both wings. TBH. Luke Wilkinson at Luton. Alright, well let's actually go to Luton and have a look at their players. Luke Wilkinson, centre back. Definitely worth a look. Definitely worth a look. I mean, technically he's awful other than his defensive stats. But he could be decent as a limited defender. Grant Hanley. Not a chance am I going to pull him out of Blackburn. Dean Parrott. Oh, shit. Dean Parrott. Centre mid. I don't really need a centre mid. I've got plenty of centre mids, I'm afraid. Messi. All right. Jonathan Woodgate. He wants so much money a week. Why is he only on 3.8k a week? What the shit? Severely lacking in match sharpness. There's a surprise. Match sharpness represents the player's readiness for competitive football. If he's lacking in recent game time, this rating will suffer. But the only way to build it up is 3 minutes on the pitch. Players low in match sharpness will struggle to keep up with the pace of a competitive match and will also be more susceptible to injury. Now, I'll get a scout report. He is transfer listed. Did you guys see him on this list? Is that where you spotted him? I don't see it. Oh no, that's midfielders, isn't it? Was he on this list? Wasn't on that list. Was he on this list? He was. That's where you saw him. GG. GG for spotting that, because I didn't. Let's go back. All midfielders. Keeping an eye on the chat. Torgan Hazard. Yes, he's going to come from Borussia Mönchengladbach back to Cambridge United, isn't he? Nicky Rowe could actually be okay. Where is he? He's at Notts County. He's a centre mid. Nicky Rowe used to play on the right hand side of midfield, didn't he, at Torquay? Pretty sure he used to play on the right hand side of midfield. Never mind. Callum Preston. Who dat? Callum Preston. A goalkeeper at Cruel. I don't need a goalkeeper, bro. I've got three goalkeepers already. I've got three already, you see. Well, let's advance a little bit and then we'll have a look at some others. Gleeson's listed. Which Gleeson, Forza Pretender? Stephen or Daniel? Well, let's just have a look, shall we? Dan Gleeson, he's a coach at Lowestoft now. He's a coach at Lowestoft? Really? Because Dan Gleeson was one of the best right backs that we had at Cambridge back in the day. He was a rock star. I mean, he was always. You could guarantee during a game that Dan Gleeson would go down with a knock and need medical attention at some point during the game, but he was a very good right back. Villa have got a chance here. Never mind, the ball went out for a goal kick. I'm actually going to scout Dan Gleeson. I'm not going to sign Akin Fenwa. Please don't spam the chat, Rasmus. But Noah Sonko. Can't find him, bro. You have to bear in mind, I'm in League 2, so I'm not going to have the best of scouting resources. Bresson Belonga would never count. He's obviously first team at Forest. Leo Chambers. Who's that? Leo Chambers, a right back at West Ham. He's bloody quick. We don't need a right back, though. That's the only thing. I'll scout him, but, you know, we don't need a right back. Chelsea Hammer West Brom. Who's scored? Out of curiosity. Willian Cesc and Gary Cahill. Bojin. Right, Zubar report. Club cannot currently afford the player. Why? Why can we not currently afford the player? I've got loads of money. Have I got a limit on how much I can offer people? Look, estimated cost 73,000, wage demands of four grand. I've got plenty of money to be able to afford that. Why would it be saying to me that I club cannot currently afford the player? Is there a wage cap in place that I'm unaware of? $40,000. Make an offer. We'll view the report. I reckon he's not as good as Mark Roberts or Leon Legg. Still would be decent though, because he can play in all positions. Richard Wood. Yeah, I thought he would be extremely good, but apparently no interest in joining us from Rotherham, who are in the Championship. Which is unsurprising, but you never know. Ryan Woods from Shrewsbury. I don't need a centre mid though, bro. It's the only thing. Elias Jesus, how am I supposed to pronounce that surname? Are you sure you spelled that right? Elias Cha? No, you must have spelled that wrong. Sorry, Freddy. No idea who the hell you're on about. Tom Thorpe. That rings a bell, but I don't know why. Autumn Thorpe. Yep, we're not going to find him by doing that, are we? Rotherham centre-back. Valued at almost £1 million on £5,000 a week. First team at Rotherham, not a chance. Stephen Mallon. He's a midfielder, though, isn't he? As in central midfielder, Stephen Mallon, yeah. Centre mid. I don't need a central midfielder, you see. Aaron Martin. Who's Aaron Martin? Aaron Martin. Centre back from Coventry. His first team at Coventry in League One, though. He would probably not come to me. We'll get a scout report nonetheless. What about some wide midfielders now? We've been scouting a lot. We've scouted a lot of centre-backs. Let's start having a look at some wide midfielders. Adam Johnson, lol. Adam Johnson's on the transfer list. Fuck off, Adam Johnson. You're going down for nonsense. He's a pedophile. He's a pedophile. Fuck off, Adam Johnson. You're going down for nonsense. Derek Boritiger. He's on £24,000 a week. Not a fucking chance, mate. Not a fucking chance. Is that going to happen? Yuri Zhirkov, lol, valued at £450,000. Yeah, but same as on £55,000 a week. Luis Molt, he's a right mid, apparently. He's a striker on the game. Sorry, fam. Khan Ayan, who's that? He's a centre-back. I don't want a centre-back. What right midfielders? Callum Gribbin. Attacking midfielder central. I would like wide players, please. It's not bot working yet. It'd be very nice if it was, because I could do. We've not got put links in the chat, etc. Chez, you really do hate Sunderland. Why? I don't hate Sunderland. They're just not very good. Oh shit, Villa has scored. Who scored Villa's goal? It's 2-1 with 10 minutes to go. Someone's dead on the floor. Who's that? Oh, it's Danny Rose. Simon Dawkins. Who are you? Simon Dawkins. Derby, never going to sign for me. Can't afford him anyway. Oh, it's Jordan Ayew, was it? Are people saying Bakuna? Are people saying Jordan Ayew? Enoch Ando. I'd never get Uche Ikpeazu. Pretty sure I'd never get Ikpeazu. I don't need a striker, though. There was another one there that I wanted to look at, and I can't remember what it was. Oh well, Duncan Watmore. He's done. I can play out wide, but he's got six to nine crossing. No thanks. No thanks. Jesse Lingard would never come to a League Two side. He'd never come to a League Two side. Players like that from the BPL just will not come on loan to anyone that is outside of the, that is lower than the Championship. Ryan Hall could be a good shout. But he's on the left. It'd be better if he was on the right. To be honest. Jamie Hansen. Who are you? He's a centre-back. I don't want centre-backs. I want a wide midfielder. Tom Pett. That name rings a bell as well. I've no idea why. Stevenage. Can play both sides. See, that's the sort of player I'm after. Can play both sides. It's quite quick. Not very good stamina, though, which sucks. But he's got good dribbling. Decent first touch. Can cross a football. That's the sort of player I'm after. Just maybe with a little bit more stamina. Because obviously, if someone's going to be playing on the wings, they're going to need to be tracking forwards and backwards. Blair Turgot. Nah. David Rosenal. He's a centre back. I don't want centre backs. What about David Alvarez? I don't know anything about you. Who else have we got on this list down here? Jordan Cook, he's decent. I know Jordan Cook's good. I would definitely be interested in bringing Jordan Cook to the club. Definitely. Definitely be interested in bringing... Please don't spam the chat, Luke. But I will search for the odd player every now and again. But like I say, please don't spam the chat. Tom Lawrence. Central attacking midfielder at Blackburn, who's in the first team and valued at £825,000 a week. I'd never get him. Harry Wilson, he's the guy at Liverpool, isn't he? Not keen on him. Martin Boyle. Right midfielder. Crossing a 4-9. It's just not good enough. He's got great dribbling and he's good at penalties, but he can't pass and he can't cross. Not exactly what I'm looking for in a winger, to be honest. Mark Cullen. That name rings a bell as well. So many familiar names. He's a striker, though. Don't watch strike. Ah, he was at Luton, wasn't he? Last year on FM, yeah. Dilemma for Tanner Erkin. Alright. Oh no, I can't turn down Stoke. I'll have a look at Roof from Oxford. Have a look. Roof. Come on, Roof from Oxford. Fantastic finishing. Can cross, has got pace. He's not very strong. His technique's good though. His passing's not the best. I will definitely give him a cheeky scout. We'll give him a cheeky scout. He's quite expensive though. £575,000. I mean. We've had a look at Tom Lawrence. Lionel Cole, I'll have a look at. I mean, I remember him from last year's FIFA. We've got him on loan from Fulham. And he's at Shrewsbury on loan from Fulham already. So we won't be able to get Lionel Cole, unfortunately. Season ticket sales have been announced. So we've got 2,000 season ticket sales. Scott Tancock. Oh, yes, we had a look at him. So he was recommended, wasn't he? Very one-footed, apparently. And not that good a centre-back. We could probably do better, to be honest. We could probably do better. O'Connor report, again. Could probably do better. Got Brentford next, which is not going to be a good game. Paris Kellen Hall, that name rings a bell as well. It's O, isn't it? Yeah, Cohen Hall. Millwall. I'll get a scout report on him. Because I do like the look of him. Right, we've got a press conference. What are your thoughts on playing a team the size and stature of Brentford? A little way in expectation for us to win, but I don't think it's as hard as people to say. Going to be a fantastic occasion. Some people are suggesting that the team could cause a big upset. I'm not making any predictions. Yeah, we're not making any predictions. Josh King would never come. Almost every single suggestion you give me, Luke, is far, far too good. You need to lower your expectations, bro. I'm never going to be able to bring those sort of players into the club, unfortunately. Zubarov and negotiated. Club's interested. Ourselves and Eastleigh. Really?
Really?
Do I? Zubar. Stefan Zubar. Is he related to Ronald? I don't know if he's related to Ronald at all. Because Ronald Zubar was a decent defender back in the day. We'll offer him 50. Because we offered him 40 before, didn't we? Downing report. Player currently had no interest in joining us, which is understandable. He's incredible, though. I just wanted to scout him out of interest, to be honest. Meekings. Centre back. Cali Thistle. No interest in joining us. He does look fantastic, though, but he's currently playing European football at Kelly. Probably not going to come to League 2, is he? TBH? Gaffney, Akinde and Hughes were all in the team of the week. Well done, lads. The itch on my back that just will not go away. Alright, Brentford. I think we've got Carlisle away. Great. Ba 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 da ba ba. Boo 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 de doo. Let's play Sam Besant in the cup. Keith Keane at right back. Keith Keane at right back. George Taft could play centre back, can't he? Yeah. I'll play Taft on the left, though. Play Taft there. Greg Taylor's still on his way back from injury. Liam Hughes, really? I'm just going to put a little leg back in. And then left back, we'll go with... What's Harrison's dunk? But Harrison's dunk? What's Harrison Dunk's tackling like? 9. Well, Greg Taylor is the left back, so we'll play Greg Taylor at left back, and I might put Harrison Dunk left mid. So I want to put a weaker side out because obviously I don't really care about the Capital One Cup, but at the same time we don't want to get outclassed as per the requests from the board for this competition. But Morrissey there, is he any good in attack or no? He's not, but he can play. We'll start Keith Keane rather than bringing him off the bench. We'll play Harrison Dunk on the left. And then we'll give Joao Rodriguez a go up top. Alongside Barry Corr. Makes sense to me, don't you think? Don't you think? Yes, I do. Yes, yes. Elliot Omazuzi. Josh Coulson on the bench. Mikey on the bench. Berry, Ryan Donaldson, and Jordan Slew. You've only selected 10 outfield players. Have I really? I don't have a right back. That's because I put Keith Keane at right back and then I've put him in centre mid as well. That was a silly decision, wasn't it? Yes. Yes. Let's put Luke Berry in, and then we will select a different substitute. Liam Hughes, you know what? Yeah, no, we'll play Berry. Auto's number. There we go. Auto's number, that's a word. Nicky Barmby, yeah, that's a great shout. Hey Dave. Willkommen im Stream. If that makes any sense in German, which I'm not sure it does. That is a good focus on what we could do today. They're playing at 4-4-1-1. Okay. Showing less vibe onto his weaker side would limit the threat he poses considerably. Okay, good. Just going to calmly say, well, huge underdog, so there's no pressure. Chill out, lads. You'll be all right. I'm not expecting anything from this game at all. Oh, Harry Kane's just scored a third for Tottenham, has he? Well, that was a pretty simple finish. He couldn't miss from there, but it was still a very good finish. That's a very good finish, actually, from Harry Kane. I'll give him that. Corner to Brentford after 2 minutes. Cleared away by Gerald Morrissey. Good. Biddy, I'm not going to sign Pozo. It's not going to happen. Oh, that's good football. With that turn, he completely sold two defenders, but Hoffman was offside. Lol. Getting dominated here, though. You're going to buy a computer purely for FM. You can play FM on Mac. But probably doesn't run. I don't know how well it runs on Mac. If you stream... I don't know whether... Yeah, you could probably stream FM, Kiz. Because it's not that graphically intensive. Although, it depends. That's a finish and a half, isn't it? If your internet could take it, I'd definitely say stream FM, because A, you're good at the game, and B, you know what you're talking about. So you'd probably be really entertaining. It runs like you, an absolute dumpling. We're getting fucking smashed right now by Brentford, to be honest. Philip Hoffman, is he the guy from... No, he's not the guy I was thinking of. Never mind. We're doing fucking shite. But I'm playing a really weak side, so I don't care about this competition. Is that better, Beardy? Make the stats smaller so the pitch is bigger. That's a good block. Oh. They're quite good at finishing, aren't they, these guys? I don't know when it's out on mobile and tablet, Rogers, to be honest. You'd have to ask, you'd have to tweet them or Google it. Main changes, I don't really know, to be honest. They've changed the aesthetic of the game, as you can see. It does look different. More different than previous years have done. I'm just going to assertively say... expect to see much better from you, because that wasn't being good enough. You'd have to Google it, mate. I don't know what's different this year. I just blindly buy FM games year on year because I like Football Manager. I don't really pay attention to what's new and what's not. There is that new draft mode, but I only know that there is a new draft mode. I don't know anything about the draft mode. That's going to be a penno, isn't it? Fuck's sake, Greg. Fuck's sake, Greg. Damn it, Greg. Tweet them about Android and they said later on this year. Alright. Well, that's 3-0. We are kind of getting outclassed. Well, I don't care about the Capital One Cup. I just wanted to play a weaker side. I don't mind that we're getting hammered. doesn't bother me. Let's put Liam Hughes on in a minute. I'm going to put Jordan Slew on up top for Joe Rodriguez. I could put Liam Hughes at left back, but it's probably the weakest position that he plays on the pitch. I'm going to put Liam Hughes at centre-back and then move George Taft to right-back. Yo to the low. I have some faces and logos. Yeah, Gunners for the treble. I just moved across the ones I had from FM15. Hey, Nightbot's back. Nightbot's working. Barry Cors picked up a chest injury. That's good. Do you remember... Let me pause that so I can point that out. Do you remember last year... someone wanted to know the uptime. Do you remember last year I was constantly saying every time it said they picked up a knock, I wish I knew what the knock was so that you could make a decision about what they... You know, whether you needed to take them off or not. A chest injury, he could probably play on with that. So we will play on. I will keep on. Come on, Morrissey, don't get caught in the middle like that. It's just schoolboy stuff. I haven't played Pro Evo so far this year, no. I do need to grab a copy, though. I do need to grab a copy. You want me to sign Abel Hernandez from Hull at Cambridge United? Okay, I'll do that right away. Go on, Barry. Well done, Barry. That was brilliant. That's fine. Assertively, I can't fault you. Nobody expected us to win, but you gave it everything. Switched off. Fine, bollocks to you. I don't care about that result. It's not a problem. Brentford Coast Bars use. Physio report Barry Core out for 3 to 4 weeks. Great. Leave to physio. Besant makes Cambridge debut. Concedes 3 goals. It's fine. We're playing Championship side. Having chosen to rest a number of key players, you must be regretting that decision. Not really. And it will show as the season unfolds. Alan Jones scored a penalty. He'll learn from it and come back better. Do you have any thoughts on Carsley? Regarding Carsley, what, the manager? Lee Carsley's the manager? Hello, mate. He was at Everton for fucking years, wasn't he? Yeah. Lee Carsley, Everton player from 2002 to 2008. Fucking hell. Fucking hell. Regarding Carsley and Brentford. Gives us a chance to concentrate elsewhere. Well, that defeat is your first. We'll try our best to get back to winning ways. How do you, we're good friends, never similar outlook on football. Was it unfortunate to come against Philip Hotman? He played very well. Tisdale spotted at Griffin Park. Well done, Tisdale. Well done, mate. Quick pick. Clearing tyre selection. View report. Ah, that's where I remember Burke from. He was a youngster at Forest last year when we had him on when we were playing FM. No intention of joining us permanently. He's already on loan at Falkirk this season. But we could look into signing him. Add to shortlist indefinitely. We could look into signing him second season. And the report on Innes, Wayne Innes, is currently on loan in League One, presumably, yeah, at Port Vale. Right, Fares. Who is on my shortlist currently? Ruben Loftus-Cheek, we can remove. Reece Oxford, we can remove. Don't show this message. John Swift, we can remove. Alex Kawamia, we can remove. Connor Townsend. Why is he even on my list? That guy we can remove. Sam Byrne we can remove. Ola Aina went to Scunthorpe instead of us, but we'll leave him on there just in case. Glenn Kamara we'll remove. And Stefan Zuba. We're still in a bid for him, so I'll leave him there for now. I'm just going to go to the toilet quickly, and then we'll start searching for a few more of your suggestions in the chat. So I will be right back.
Hi.
Right, I think I'm gonna pull out of this deal. I don't want Zuba. Report on Paul. No interest in joining us on loan. Really? You'd rather just sit and rot in Man United's fine, suit yourself. Lewis Dodds. Not a worthwhile signing. Apparently. He's good at crossing though. And look, if I highlight that, stamina's great, his pace isn't the best, but his work rate's okay, technique's good, passing's good, first touch is good, dribbling and crossing are good. His vision's not the best, his teamwork isn't that high, but I don't know about Lewis Dodds, I don't know. I like him, but is he going to be good enough? Fuck it, I'm bidding for him. I'm bidding for him, bollocks to it. Bollocks to it, I'm bidding for him. Mendes Lang. Okay. Oh Jesus, they come back immediately. They want 35. Oh, they want 37 and a half, alright. Well, how about 28? Chris Welpdale, yes, would be a quality signing. I concur. Welpdale would be available for £75,000. Yep. I would much rather Chris Welpdale than Lewis Dodds, but we will offer 60k. Oh, we'll do that. And Luke Wilkinson report. Some doubts over player something, it said. Some doubts may be worth tracking the player. Very one-footed, fairly slow. Really? It's not that slow. Actually, not that slow. Teamwork's high, positioning's decent. Good leadership, good determination, good, solid strength. It's good in the air. Fuck it, I'm gonna bid for him. Gonna fucking do it. It's done. Naki Wells, bloody hell. Naki Wells. Is he still at Huddersfield? He is still at Huddersfield. £7.5 million. He's valued at £7.5 million. Are you sure? Bloody hell. Bloody hell! Just look at Pozo, you will never ask again. Okay. Oh, shit. Jose Angel Pozo. I can't see his stats. He's on loan at Almeria have bought him for £350,000. There you go. And I can't scout him because he's too far away. Can't afford to scout him. There you go. I've looked at Pozo. And there's nothing I can tell you about him because he doesn't tell me any of his stats. Ryan Tafazzoli. Oh. Ryan is Tafazzoli. He's not very quick off the mark. He played for City, really? Played for Cambridge City back in 2011. Well, I never. I'll get a scout report on him. Cristiano Ronaldo, thanks all. I'll go straight out and put a bid in. Mendes Lang, yes. Sorry, Rhys, you've been putting Mendes Lang for ages and I keep going, yes, Mendes Lang, and then looking at someone else. Nathaniel Mendes Lang. I'll get a scout report on him. What was the other one? It was Will Atkins, wasn't it? We looked at him already, though, haven't we? The guy from Southend, yeah, well, I think we've looked at him already. Have I got a scout out on him at the minute? Oh, I'll scout him anyway. Even though his stats don't look... Oh, he's got 14 passing, I mean. I suppose he's got 14 passing, isn't he? Yeah, that's all right, I suppose. It's not bad. Get a better scout. It's not a case of having a better scout, Beardy. It's financial. Can't afford to scout to Spain. Reggie Lamb, that name rings a bell as well. Reggie. Oh, he's at Mansfield as well. He went to Sweden for a year and was at Toronto. A scout report on him then, shall I? Yeah, okay. There you go, Reggie. Matt Green scoring 2 goals from the penalty spot. He was always a good goal scorer on the FM. Back in day, you know, back in the day. Everyone sub to chess so we can start a Pozo fund. Well, deal negotiated. Go on then. I'll accept it. We'll keep going in for Lewis Dodds just in case, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to go for Welpdale. Player currently has no interest in joining us. But Jonathan, we're amazing! Yeah, and you're slow as shit. Probably going to get injured all the time. Real Madrid for 3 years. And did fuck all! Absolutely fuck all. That's just a shame, because he was such a good defender. When he was at Leeds and Newcastle, he was such a good defender. It's one of the saddest stories of a career. Dan Gleeson! Some doubts over his ability. I just wanted to have a better look at his stats, to be honest. Oh, Danny! And the willing to negotiate over loop with you. Want 300 and what? Oh, you can kind of understand why they'd want that. Because he is pretty goddamn good. But I'm not really too sure I want to pay that much. I'll give you 140. Could have a look at Barcham, but he's kind of pacing not much else, isn't he, Peachy Boy? Let's have a look. Barcham. And he's fucking quick. Wasn't he at Gillingham? He was. He's quick. He can cross. He can dribble. He's finishing shite. He's only left-sided, though. That's the only thing. I want someone that's predominantly right-sided, but can play on both. Right, Carlisle away. Brazovan. Omazuzi. Is Matt Roberts back yet? Not yet, but he could be soon. Go Leon Legg. I'm actually going to play George Taft again at centre back. I'm going to do it. I've done it. It's happened. And Mikey at left back. Connor on the right. Donaldson in the middle. Berry Holden. Oh, and he almost put Liam Hughes there. No, Jeff Hughes on the left. And we can't really break up the relationship between Rory Gaffney and John Akinde, can we, really, after the way they scored two goals each in the previous game? I would like it if we could be slightly more defensively solid, though, to be completely honest. I'm going to leave that as it is. Right, on the bench. Chris Dunn. Greg Taylor. Josh and Keith Keane. Keith will go for his count as a centre-mid as well. So we'll put... he's not that fit, Harrison Dunk. He's not that fit, you know. He's not... Liam Hughes is just a good bench player. Did you score any goals? He did score goals pre-season, didn't he, Jordan Slew? Go on then, we'll put Jordan Slew on the bench. We'll do the same with Robbie Simpson as well. Come on, the boys! Third in the league after one game. Although we were second, but Mansfield have gone above us because they won that second game. 6-4. Carlisle are favourites, actually. How did they get on in their first game? Carlisle, they drew. Don't know what the score was. They're playing 3-1-4-2. Okay. Calmly. Go out there and enjoy yourselves today. No pressure, lads. No pressure! In before we lose heavily. Go on, Connor. Never mind. We were 3-0 up, 2-0 up by this point in the first league game. How's that for a whip? Actually, not that good. You better get there first. Thank you, Ryan. Go on, Connor. On the overlap, or not, into Jeff Hughes. He did nothing with it. They kicked it only as far as Elliot Omazuzi. Oh, bloody hell. He shot. I wasn't expecting that. I can't loan Pozo, Biddy. He's been sold to Almeria. I'm not going to do anything with Pozo, ever. We've got another corner. Come on, the boys. I'm not keen on George Green's saw, to be honest. It's flicked on. Didn't necessarily head it towards goal, though, did he? Schmelzer's on a counter. Daniel Powell, he's quick, isn't he? But I don't know whether he's got much else to his game. Oh, threw himself into that tackle. Don't concede, lads. Thank you. Halo 5 was installed. Nice. You'll have to let me know what it's like, because, although I presume it's just like every other Halo, so. Just with a few more shiny bits. Oh, boys, we're dominating this game again. That's a lovely ball into Rory Gaffney, who hits the post, but he was offside. Oh, John Akindo was about to tap that into an empty net. He was about to tap that into an empty net. That's a good ball by Connor. John Akindo brings it down. Can he get a turn in? Gaffney! Saved. Oh! Connor Newton with a shot again. Bloody hell. Bloody hell! I've got the large database on, Fabulous Chicken. I do have large database on right now, but I've only got six leagues. Or six countries, sorry. Six countries, 23 leagues. See you, Luke. Thanks for coming out to the stream again, bro. Right, half-time. We've been playing well, actually, so I'm going to assertively say I'm happy with your performance so far. Keep it up. Although Carlisle did start to get into it a little bit more towards the end of the half. Had a couple of chances. We're looking for centre-backs and wide midfielders, Master CT. We think we might have found a wide midfielder in Chris Welpdale from Stevenage. So we'll have to wait and see. Now, we fell apart in the second half against Newport, but we were able to get the win. Come on, just get the tackle in, will you? Someone tackle so he's going to play that through, and we've cleared it, it's fine. Or it might not be fine, because they've kicked it straight back to the box. It's fine. I used to go Cambridge every week, Drone Dream, but I can't at the minute, because of health conditions. Go on, Jeff, that's a good ball. Akindé! What a signing he's been! See you, JW. Akindé! £195,000 well spent by the sounds of things. Well, by the looks of things. On the volley, Mers. Bang! Yeah. Goal, 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 goal. Do, 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 do. What a signing, cough. Get out. In before they equalise, pretty sharpish. With a hashtag swift reply. Well up, Leon. Oh, good save. No! What a block. What a block. That was key. That was key, that was. Unless they score here instead, which they haven't. Phew. Right, let's make a change. Luke Berry is shattered, so let's bring on Keith Keane. And I may switch to defensive in a minute. Although every time I seem to switch to defensive, I always concede goals, so I'm tempted to not. There's something going on right now, but we can't see it because I've made the substitution. Here we go. Made the sub. Come on, boys. A second would put my nerves at rest. Oh, it's a nice ball. Rory! Was he onside? No.
Oh, dear.
Thought we were tuning up there, but he was off. We've looked at Ryan Innes, Master CT. He's on loan at Port Vale at the minute and unavailable. Sign Inform Pele on a pre-contract. He's a good youngster. All right, I'll get right on it. Oh, my God. They nearly equalised with the last shot of the game, but we got the win. We got the win. Just going to calmly say, well done, lads. That's a good win. Oof. We're top of the league after two games. We are top of the table. Resolving on form. Well, look, you can see, I presume these are like highlights. That's pretty cool. That's another new addition. We've got a game midweek again. Oh, it's the only thing. The only thing with lower league football, there are so many games to play. Leo Chambers might be worth keeping an eye on his development. Interested in joining us on loan. I'll be open to loaning. Not willing to let him loan. What?
Why not? Why not?
Make an offer. Report on Aaron Martin at Coventry. Some doubts, apparently, but I'm not so sure. I think he'd be pretty good. But would he want to drop from Coventry in League 1 to Cambridge in League 2? I doubt it. I doubt it. Suggest terms. Oh shit, they accepted it straight away. Wasn't expecting that. Lol. Fine, we'll do that. Luton willing to negotiate for Luke Wilkinson. How about 210? Okay, we could be making advances. Yeah, he doesn't want to come, does he? Make first offer. We'll try and make an offer for him first. Right, first team. No, key player. Transfer immediate. Contract length 3 years. He's currently on 1 point. He's currently on 1.6, was he? He's currently on 1.6. So I'll give him 1.8, we'll give him a pay rise, signing on fee of 10 grand, and suggest terms. He wants 5 grand, yeah, good luck, Sunshine, not a fucking chance. I can't afford to give you that. Yeah, never mind, alright, bye-bye. Right, offer accepted for Dodds. Ah, the Welkdale one is the one I'm most keen on, though. Right. Rotation. Only offer 650 for rotation, are you sure? Max wage. See, I've got so much money for the wage budget, but there's a wage cap with 2.6k. Which is mental. It's fucking mental, you know. I can't give you 1.3, mate. I just can't. Give you more for an appearance fee and more for a goal bonus if you want. And a signing on fee of 5 grand. Oop. Can I have a word with the board? Make board request. Finance. So yeah. I don't want them to increase the budget. The budget in itself is fine. The budget in itself is fine. It's just the cap on the cap they've put on it. But I there's no way to ask that. I'm just going to ask for a wage budget increase. Do you believe the current wage budget is sufficient? I just want to be like, okay. Okay, that's fine. I just didn't want to piss him off now that I moved into that line of. Good. He only wants 900. Hang on. Sick. Because Luke Williamson is decent, bruv. He's decent, bruv. So we'll go to offer contract. First team, immediate. I mean, if I can get him to sign, I won't be able to get him to sign for rotation because I can't offer him any fucking money, can I? I'm quite happy to offer him what he's asking for, to be honest. And Weltdale. Ah, he wants 2.4k. What's he currently on? 1.9. Key player. 2.7. How about 2.2? 2.6? How about 2.3? Yes, Chris Weltdale. Thank you very much. We could be getting places with these signs. Oh shit, Villa just beat Chelsea. 1-0. God damn. They played Falcao? Are you mental? Playing Falcao for? Because Diego Costa's injured. Alright, that's fair enough. Knee tendonitis out for 3 months? Fucking hell. Oh yeah, Tom Pett, we looked at him, didn't we? Some doubts might be worth tracking the player. He's got low stamina though, I'm not keen. Jordan Cook, no interest in joining us at all, ever. Sweet. But Jordan, you'd be quite good. I'll see what they say to a loan deal.
Yeah.
Backroom advice meeting. Sure. Right midfielder. I'm already signing right midfielders, boys, so it doesn't matter, but we'll scout them anyway. No. We should play with a standard mentality. Change mentality, fine. No. 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 Sorry, Jez. Just basically Oh, they rejected the loan offer. Piss off.
Piss off, you bastards.
See if we can get any of those deals done. And then I think that'll be us for tonight, by the time this Wimbledon game comes around. No interest in joining us. Kamar Roof. Is that so? but we're top of the league, Sunshine. Paris Cowan Hall, no interest in joining us. I mean, he's not playing though, is he? He's on $3,500 a week though. I could never afford to pay his wages. Oh, Viv Sodman Otterbor. He was the guy that they wanted me to scout, wasn't he? At Birmingham. No, he's quick. But fuck all else. No. And Harry Cornick. He's quick, decent crossing, good passing. I would be open to, if we can't bring in Tom Pett, then we might look at this guy. Indefinitely, get a scout report, yes. I've already scouted him. They've already scouted him for me, but I'll get another one. Jeff Hughes and Brazovan are in the team of the week. How long till Mark Roberts is back? Oh, a day. Okay. Okay, he's out for a day. Because getting Mark Roberts back will be key to us solidifying at the back. But that is going to bring us to a close for tonight, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure you hit the thumbs up button. And subscribe if you haven't already, and obviously check the link to the Twitch channel in the description down below so you can watch me stream this live. Those of you that are here on Twitch right now, thank you for watching. We've been around about 500 or 600 people. We're up towards 700 people again for the majority of the streams, so that was fantastic. Thank you for all of your suggestions. We'll be back again, same time, same place, tomorrow, 8:45 p.m. So obviously make sure that you come back. Feel free to follow me on Twitter. I'll put my link in the chat. Feel free to subscribe to the YouTube channel. Check out the merchandise store, which is new. So we'll definitely check that out. I'll just link that in the chat as well. But for now, that's going to be us for tonight. Thank you very much for watching. And I will see you tomorrow.